Welcome back to Let's Play Little Busters, Komari's Routes. How long's it been? August. I can't see it because the thing's in the way. Let me just move it a little bit here. Yeah, August 8th. So it's exactly 10 days later then, because it's August 18th. That would be 10 days, right? Oh boy, and what a way to begin. Come to think of it, I've saved the QR code that should lead to Kyousuke's website. Oh boy, we gotta mentally prepare ourselves for this. Yeah, what I found really exhausting yesterday, and the day before, technically. Finally got around to recording bonus parts for my Project Zero Let's Play on my main channel, Project Zero Maiden of Backwater. Because I'd already completed the Let's Play, I was like, just do some bonus parts to get the last trophies. And the last trophy took me, like, combined video-wise, 2 hours 45 minutes. It actually took longer than that, taking into account the bits where I didn't record, just playing through the damn thing, just to get more ghosts, because the last trophy I had, you had to get 30 ghosts defeated while tainted. Easier said than done, but now I'm starting to think that maybe it was a typo and it's supposed to be 20 and not 30, but besides the point, it took forever. Then on top of that, the next day when I was about to start editing this mammoth-sized, you know, record session, I realized that the 45-minute bit that I did at later on in the day, because that's when I realized there was an easier way of getting that trophy. Took 45 minutes anyway, but I realized my commentary didn't record on it, so I had to do post-commentary and then edit all that in the same day. I mean, I didn't have to do all in the same day, but sadly, yeah, the way it was so time-consuming. But it's got nothing to do with this, so let's check out Kyousuke's site. I guess this makes me a bad student as well. I turned on myself and I went to the site. So it's titled Kyousuke's One Question, One Answer. More like 100 questions, 100 answers. Well, maybe more than that. I'll scroll down on it and find a lot of questions and their answers. Looks like the concept of this site is that Kyousuke is answering questions for the entire school by himself. I wonder why on earth is motivated. Let's see. Again, it's like the screen cap software I'm using is always obscuring the top of the screen up here. So I gotta scroll down. Okay, let's move it over here for now. Number 13. Why is it start at number 13? Did you just pick my random nickname, K-Man? A question for Natsume-senpai, known for his multitude of techniques. Please tell me what is an effective ultimate technique to use when you're up against multiple enemies alone. Answer if I reveal it to you, I will no longer be able to use it myself, but okay, I'm gonna tell you. This technique becomes more effective the more enemies there are. It allows you to escape from any battle, even if you're unarmed. Real trump card, so to speak. It's called the ultimate technique, Shuffle Time. It's really simple. You only have to yell, Shuffle Time, start, and then you go into, No, that wasn't the all-out attack. No, thinking of after battles in Persona, where it's like, Shuffle Time. Pick your own persona out of these random cards. Speaking of which, I still haven't got around to Let's Play Persona 3 on my main channel. I'll do that when I learn my second playthrough, which I didn't originally intend to do, but it ended up happening, of Digimon World Next Order, or the Rune Factory Ocean's Destiny. Whichever one ends first, then I'll stop Persona 3. I'm also considering playing it again off-screen, just to, you know, as a practice run, and also, you know, because I could play it on New Game Plus, so that, you know, off-screen, if I, you know, haven't, which will inevitably happen, gotten all the social links in the main playthrough, I can just go to that save file to show them instead. That is assuming I managed that. I remember playing Persona 5 a while back. I played through it twice. Second time was on New Game Plus with all the max stats. I was confident I'd get all the social links, but this stupid shop owner guy, his social links was moving so slow and I ran out of time and couldn't max it out. He's the only one There's always that one. Still annoyed by that. I still have not even bothered to play for the game again just to try to get that. I think it was the last trophy I needed. I can't remember. Doesn't matter. It's got nothing to do with this. Just rambling about Persona because, you know, shuffle time. Let's see how ridiculous this looks in Japanese, though. Yeah, it doesn't look that ridiculous. I mean, it is a wall of text, but it's a wall of text in English as well. The reason I just did that is because I'm like, what must it have been like for the translator, you know? It's like, okay, here are multiple walls of text where Kyousuke just explains absolute nonsense for God knows how many times. You gotta translate every single bit of it. Craziness. Wrong thing. The phrase shuffle time itself is a finishing move. They will get the impression that a shuffle time has started since you so said. Some of them will start looking around, some will start inspecting the weapons they have at hand. They will ponder what exactly is going on, what exactly has been shuffled. I've seen some even start chanting at changing places, people around them. And whilst they're dumbfounded by shuffle time, you can make, again, it's like, it's too, like, over here, for example. I've moved the window so it doesn't obscure it. There's like two different things on screen. It's annoying. You can make a run for it when it finally dawns on him that nothing is in fact being shuffled. You'll already be taking a shower at home as if nothing happened. That's a trick. I really need a shower. Then end up having a shower yesterday because of all that editing. What a thought-provoking answer. Let's see. Number 12, nickname Yokozuga Kare. Yosuke Senpai, any personal antidotes of your heroic adventures to overcome the tribulations of some particular test? Answer, you should ask Master. I believe he's had more than his fair share of those. He always tries his best to put something in the answer column, even if he doesn't know the answer. We all should learn something from him. Actually, I happen to have his test results from world history with me, so let me give you some examples. Question, who are the three people that comprise the triumvirate, can't pronounce, in 43 BC? Answer, Octavianus, Andonis, and Macedonus. Explanation, on first glance, it looks almost natural to see Master as part of the world history. It's possible to make one's name look legit by subjecting you or nurse to it. It's a clever answer that targets the blind spot of world history. There are a lot of blind spots in world history when you think about it. Because, you know, the only things we know about history are based on, you know, archaeological finds and written records. Masato... something. So he's basically trying to, you know, blend in with these, you know, ancient names. It's like, yes, Masato fits into world history perfectly. Wait, what's that? Oh, yeah, still on the question. Question. When Attila invaded Rome in 452, who was it that persuaded him to withdraw? Answer, me, Ore. Explanation, the correct answer is Leo, Rio. But for an unknown reason, it was reversed, and as a result, Masato became a historical figure once more. This is so nonsensical. Notice how it basically just says Ore there? You know, I was highlighted like that was like me. Because that's basically what it means. They just threw it in there because I guess it's relevant to this bit where it's like explaining Ryo and he like somehow ended up gone. He basically had it backwards. Look at that. Ore, Re, Ore. So he just got them backwards on the kana there. That is such a Masato thing to do, though. Question: what's the most primitive hominid discovered in 1924 in the Republic of Botswana? Botswana land at the time of discovery? Answer: Auto Tora Tora X. Or would it be EX? Explanation: he was close to the answer. Australopithecus, but his memory was vague, and after searching for something that resembled the correct answer, he came up with a name fit for a mysterious super robot. His creativity is outstanding. I'll talk about my own stories another time. That might indeed happen. What the hell does that even mean? I like how his base highlight starts and he's like, no. But no, we can't resist. Let's see. Nickname Clayton. I can't even see the... You know, let's get it out of it. Number 11. We gotta keep track of this. Make sure that we don't end up repeating. Question. Well, like, I'm gonna remember all these. I have a question for Natsube, sent by who's rumored to be a closet Destiny fan. That's Destiny Land, Destiny Sea, and I hear there will be an old Destiny something. It's obvious what they're referencing, but, you know, for copyright reasons. What will it be and what attractions will it have? Please give me details. Kind of think of it, you know, go back to Persona. Didn't I do this last time as well? It's like, I remember in Persona 5, where they go to a theme park, which is clearly supposed to be, you know, Disneyland or whatever. Or at least based on it, but it's like, no, it's Destinyland, see? It's a totally different thing. I mean, for a themed park like that, you know, it's not like they could be like, yeah, that's copyrighted, that's our stuff. It's like, no. If it doesn't say Disney, then it's not Disney. And if it doesn't show Disney characters, it's technically not Disney. It's just loosely based on it. Answer: according to my information, after Destiny Land and Destiny Sea, there will be Destiny Deserts. Gotta scroll that again. Get lost in the boundless wandering hell. Try riding on a one-humped camel and run on one hump a camel. Observe cactus growth at Cactus Watcher. Don't appreciate the taste of water at I'm still alive. Well, you know, they should totally then have, you know, I survived wandering hell t-shirts. That's what I heard, so you can see it's all very exciting. Oh, I fear I may have given away too much information. Pretend you didn't hear anything. What a thought-provoking answer. Hey, look, now it's highlighted. This one's like, oh, that one's so fascinating, we gotta read another one. Let's see. Number 10, nickname Reizaki Yoshi Zato. I mean, they gave names here. Wait a minute. They gave names. One of these are actually, like, part of the developer team or something like that. It's like, yeah, we'll just shove our names in there and be like, yeah, we ask these ridiculous questions. Oh, man, my throat is tickly. I should have got another drink. Question for Natsume Senpai, famous for giving birth to a new smiley. What kind of smiley is it? Answer: it has a fleeting resemblance to a seriously pissed off Bandersan. It's really only so fleeting a resemblance. If I was told that it resembles a seriously pissed off Rosan, the third foreign player, I would certainly agree with that. I'm impressed by his face, and that one's short. Let's see. Number 9, nickname Buddy Macho. Question: a question for Natsubi Senpai, famous for once reversing the Earth's rotation. What happened when you did that? Answer: for some mysterious reason, men's voices became higher than men's. Women's, I mean. That might indeed happen. But it certainly is the case for you, Riki. You don't really have a deep voice. Let's see. I mean, could you imagine? I mean, Riki, you know. Riki. Look at him. Could you imagine someone looking like this and actually having a deep voice? That would be very jarring. It'd be like seeing someone like Masato, maybe, and having a really high-pitched voice. Or even Kengo, you know? You'd think, like, they'd have, like, a kind of deep voice, and then they talk, and it's like, how are you doing? And it's like, what the fuck was that? Nickname waiting for a curveball. Question for Natsumi Senpai, who sent a ball thrown by Egawa-san in his prime flying to the back screen. What did you say when you hit the ball, and what was Egawa-san's reaction? Answer: your point of view, there's nothing more than friggin' hindsight. Why don't you try guessing what's going to happen? And it's not limited to you, but before the beginning of the season, all commentators give ambiguous comments like, it's likely going to be a scramble for a while, that's what I want is a daring prediction like, Hiroshima's going to take a strong start and won't allow any other team to catch up with them until the end of the season. And then, kazing, I can still remember how his ears kept flapping at my words and my swing even now. Wow, I didn't know this! Let's see. Number 7, nickname Soup. Question, please tell me the secret behind crushing your opponent without fouling out when you play basketball. Answer, use your key. An Asian philosophical concept that represents an invisible energy that permeates all living beings and their bodies. That might indeed happen. Let's see. Number 6. Nickname Old Book. Question. That's super simple. I heard that you've undergone special mission training on now able to use your key. Under which circumstances do you use it? Answer. When I play basketball, I need to crack my palm while fouling out.
I'm impressed by his reasonness. This is a very simple question.
Well, that's about as simple as you can get in this complete madness. Let's see.
Number 5, nickname Lagoon. Question. The question for that Super Senpai known to be obsessed with attending court hearings. Among all court hearings that you've attended so far, which one had the most dramatic developments? And why, again, do I go back to Persona? You're kind of like that one guy. You know the guy, right? Kind of looks a bit like Kyousuke now that I think about it. Persona 5, by the way. I can't remember the name of the character. What was his name? Was it Adachi or am I thinking of Persona 4? I can't remember. If I'm not mistaken, it was a trial of two brothers where a simple domestic quarrel led to physical injury. This is all because you never used fabric softener. The defendant started arguing with his younger brother, starting on... And on the witness stand, the judge took his gavel and started pounding the desk nastily after expecting the same order in the court. But he didn't. Instead, he said the following. That's enough. Look at your mother's crying. She's the one who gave birth to you. If it weren't for her, you wouldn't even be here fighting now. Don't make her cry anymore. She's old. You must treasure her. Oh, but why am I still preaching here like an old man? Some judge I am. So silly. And then he slowly stood up and left the court. I can tell that, yeah, his words. I can guess by this point. It's like I can't see the first words up in the corner, but I can kind of guess what it says. The words got through to them, and they both broke into tears and ran up to the mother with all their might. Everyone present at the court started crying too. There wasn't a single person with dry eyes. For some reason, the court's stenographer was crying more than anybody else. Court was adjourned. I mean, there was no point to it anymore. There's never been a trial quite as touching, and never will. One thing I must add is that I've never seen that judge again after that day.
I'm impressed by his persuasiveness. Let's see. Number 4, nickname Arts. Question, I've recently come across a strange phenomenon. I wake up every morning to find that my alarm clock has stopped. Is this some sort of omen? Answer, your alarm clock is bad news. When this happens to an alarm clock, it will eventually start moving counterclockwise, and in the end, explode. So before it blows your head off, you have to wake up right when it goes off. That'll fix it. This is so interesting. Fascinating, even. Let's see.
Number 3, nickname, Kyousuke Star. Or maybe these are just actual names, and they're just kind of thrown in as jokes.
When I eat yeast into yakisaba, and pour out the hot water, there's always a strange dang sound. What causes it? Tap this noodles, which consists of yakisaba in a container. Each yakisaba is prepared by filling the container with hot water, draining, and have the noodles are cooked out and added in sauce.
Vendor water from the container can be tricky, and accidents can occur, resulting in noodles falling into sink and ruining meals. Answer, it's actually dang. Where's my noodles? A complaint from the sink, incidentally. If you also throw away the noodles, the sound will transform into a high-pitched ZAM!
Oh, well, that wasn't high-pitched ZAM!
It might surprise you, but it's actually a sound of sincere gratitude from the sink. Wait. It's like I'm not really pausing much throughout all this, as you can clearly tell. But it's like, but it's actually a sign of sincere gratitude from the sink. When you get the chance, give it a try. What a thought provoking answer. Let's see. You know what'd be hilarious if there was like a very serious question and answer mixed in there somewhere? You know, I gotta get a drink, my freaking throat. Right, back to the insanity that is Kyosuke's forum. Number 2, nickname Shorthead Namihira. Question, a question for the legendary Natsume Senpai, who bought a gigantic superhuman to a draw. What kind of battle was that? Yeah, so first of all, that guy is huge. In order to make up for the difference in height, I had to wear thick soil boots, and I mean thick, like internet thick. You know, when people, you know, ride with 2 C's. Moving on, soil boots. They could no longer be considered shoes. I mean, they couldn't walk in those things. Physical difference was no longer a problem, so it was all about guts. We started wrestling, exchanging one blow out for another. It was a real struggle. The kids had never seen a battle that nasty. I was at Polly's disadvantage as well as his time and finally started. Now I need a drink. Good God, man. Reading all this is just... Because there's just walls of text after walls of text. It's not like the usual way, you know. I can pause for a while, but I can't just do the talking, you know? And it's not like this is relevant to the plot at all. The only reason I'm, you know, doing this is because I remember seeing a comment on an earlier part asking if I would, you know, do the Kyosuke forum thing. So here we are again, basically. This time he finally started blinking. I got shot by his light beam in the process, but it didn't hurt as bad as I was told. He couldn't retreat before defeating his enemy. I think it was past 3 minutes already. He was growing weak and getting all wrinkly. He must have been under pressure. Finally proceeded. I managed to hold... Hold back a burp. That's what I did. Where was I again? Must have been under pressure. I managed to hold my own somehow, even though he was getting wrinkly. 10 more seconds and I'd have been in trouble. You know, annoying thing about having a can is once you open the can, you know, can't just put it down, man, at least not for me anyway. I don't like to do that because, you know, all stuff could just flow from the air like dust and land into it. I mean, you could apply the same to, you know, having a glass or something, you know. Water, whatever, let's resume. I don't even have anywhere to put the can down properly. What a thought-provoking answer. Let's see. Number 1, nickname Ken. Question, a question for Kyosuke Senpai, known as the Prince of the Ice Rink, who conquered the world of figure skating. For some reason, when he was going on about, you know, the Prince of Ice Rink and who conquered the world, didn't even think figure skating there. Just made me think of the South Park movie, Bigger, Longer, Uncut, where they sing a song about that one ice skater. For some reason, making it just like, yeah, this guy was a badass. He, like, you know, he beat up all these historical figures and all, like, just because he's that badass and stuff. It made no sense. Yeah, an original technique called Tropical. What kind of technique is it? Answer, it's an original technique that I conceived. One of those techniques where you retain the same pose while skating. And members of the Figure Skating Association witnessed this technique, they all exclaimed in unison, "Oh, how tropical." So that's where the name comes from. God damn it, I always have to move the screen. The distinguishing features of it, as the name implies, is its tropicalness. When I take this pose, my whole body starts radiating tropicalness. So tropical that their reaction is very understandable. When I first performed this technique, my coach argued that it was too tropical. But in the end, it brought me victory. So did he just turn into a Ludicolo? Is that that Pokemon that's constantly dancing? However, after the competition was over, various entertainers, red pandas, earless seals, and such started mimicking my tropical technique. In my eyes, that wasn't anything tropical though. It hardly qualified as fruity. It became something of a fad, and I had to give up on it before it became too commonplace. I still remember what my coach told me at that time. You can no longer squeeze out fresh tropicals. I'm impressed by his business. Honestly, as stupid as that was, I can totally picture that being an ad. I mean, picture it, man. Ads are freaking weird. That would be like an ad for some kind of fruit drink. Just like, this has nothing to do with anything. But it just ends with, it's like, the ultimate freaks. It's like, buy our drinks. Let's see. Now we're going in reverse. Number 25, nickname Maito. Question, I heard you've traveled into the future. What was it like? Answer, just what you'd expect from the future. All cars were hovering 1 centimeter above the ground. Just 1 centimeter. And they were flying about on the road. Can you imagine that? 1 centimeter. Jesus Christ, that's crazy. When I called a cab, it landed in an instant. I got inside and suddenly felt a strong G-force. And the car instantly went up 1 centimeter. It was a very cybernetic vibe. I'm impressed by this. Let's see. Number 24. Nickname Aomaki Kakiyami. Question for Kyousuke-senpai, who studied traditional Japanese musical instruments. What did they put inside taiko and suzumi drums? Traditional Japanese musical instrument made of hides wrapped on the sides of the drum body. It is played by beaten drum with wooden rods called bachi. Taiko, a traditional Japanese percussion instrument made of hides around and played by beaten drum. I've read it twice somehow. Shaped like an hourglass, is played by beating the drum body directly with hands. So, kind of like a East Asian version of bongo drums? I don't know. Answer, there's stuff with mechanical stuff to the limits. For instance, cartridges with Japanese drum written on them. By the way, if you stick distortion cartridges inside, sound will get more rock-like. What a thought-provoking answer. I just now picture it, and it's like, what could be more rock than anything? A drum kit made out of rocks. Let's see. Number 23, nickname Yamamoto Touchout. A question for Kyousuke-senpai, famous palindrome experts. Like all palindromes that you have created, what's the one you've got the most confidence in? Answer, Gateman sees name, Garishman sees name tag. I have no idea what it might prefer to. What a thought-provoking answer. Let's see. Number 22, nickname Bum. Question, I heard rumors that you're a big fan of the seafood-laden family. Kyousuke-senpai. Can you tell me what it is? What it was that the youngest boy said only one time except for Hi Babu? Answer, look, I was born already. It was a remark born from the shock she received upon learning that she was named after salmon eggs. I'm impressed by his status. Let's see. Seriously, I do wonder what the hell went through their minds, their heads, when they wrote all this stuff. It's like, what were they thinking? It's like, let's just write any old stupid stuff down. It's just like, yeah, this is complete nonsense, but hey, it's optional nonsense. Nickname Bachi. Question, what's that buzzword you gave birth to that claimed first prize in last year's Buzzwords of the Year contest? Answer, speak with ambiguous nuances. I coined this famous expression while I was playing the role of the hostage negotiator in the robbery case last year. Recall, thanks to this phrase, I managed to extend the negotiation by 2 hours, and the operation resulted in a successful arrest. Damn, I'm not even 30 minutes into the recording, I'm already losing my voice here. I'm impressed by his persuasiveness. Good God, it just never ends. I mean, yeah, you know, impressed by his persuasiveness actually applies there. I mean, he was able to keep the hostage situation under control and get the arrest, you know? That's persuasiveness. Let's see. Number 20, nickname Rose RS. Listen, a message from Taiwan. Kyousuke-san, you left a mountain of legends about yourself in Taiwan last year. One of them is that apparently you'd be in the leader of the Rose Squadron. What kind of job is that? And so, oh, Taiwan, that brings back so many memories. Rose Squadron was a TV program for kids. There was a man dancing flamenco with a rose in his mouth during the credits. Yes, it was me. God damn it, again, I can't see the first word. My only appearance in the show itself was during the last episode, and my only line was, "This rose," which I spoke when I suddenly made my appearance right before the end. And then, as if nothing happens, I was yet again dancing with a rose in my mouth during the credits. I'm impressed by the faithfulness.
Let's see.
Number 9, he nicknamed Vilger. A question for Kyousuke, senpai who would courageously fight even against 30 thugs. What would you do against someone armed with a knife? I think a real man must always fight barehanded. And so, sorry, I'd run. That's gotta be his most understandable answer yet, honestly. What a thought-provoking answer. Or alternatively, like, what do you do in this fight? Shoot him in the face. Bring a knife to a gunfight, fool. Let's see. Number 18, nickname Oi-san. Kyousuke-senpai, are there other wonderful ways to spend your holidays besides watching all the recorded TV programs that are piled up? Answer, sorry, but I can't really think of anything besides that. This is so interesting. What a great answer. Let's see.
Number 17, nicknamed Shortbeard Cat. Please teach me the correct way to wear briefs.
Ah, yes, I remember this one.
You wear them on your face.
What a thought-provoking answer. Just picture it. Kyousuke just randomly shows up on screen. His regular character model, but he's wearing his underwear on his face like that. You'd be like, what the hell, Kyousuke?
Let's see.
16, nicknamed Mask. Question, Kyousuke-senpai, I heard that you have undergone training to learn to use ki. What should I do to be able to use it too?
And so this is something I learned afterwards, but using ki is very similar to mixing two songs together if you're a DJ. See, machine, rhythm, BPM, and creating a seamless transition between songs mixing is very similar to using ki. That's why for your training, first start by getting your hands on a turntable and aiming to become a better DJ.
I'm impressed by his laziness. Let's see. Number 15, nickname Forever 6 years old. A question for Kyosuke Senpai, who once passed high, with his vocal techniques. What's the best live performance that you know of?
Well, the answer is underwear on all instruments. I'm impressed by his laziness.
Let's see. Number 14, nickname Poopepepo. Poopepepo.
A question for Kyousuke Senpai, who once went to the Papupepepon Temple. What a name. Where is that Papupepepon Temple? Answer, it's situated on the small island of Pepepon, surrounded by the Papapi Sea. However, there are no ships that go directly to the islands, and your best bet would be to ask the local fishermen to let you aboard. But make sure you never mention Papupepepon Temple. They're terrified of the Papupepepon, or more precisely, the goddess Papopina, worshipped there.
Wait a minute.
I know, it seems a bit familiar to me. There's a channel I watch that I've watched for years now. Probably the first Let's Play channel, although it was very different compared to other ones, because he has... The channel called Zeta Plays, right? And he set out on a girl over a decade ago and is still going to this day to play every game on the NES, Super Nintendo, and Sega Mega Drive Genesis. And in that quest, he's come across a lot of weird Japanese games. And there was one game, it might have even had multiple games, that I think might have been based... Well, it was clearly had a manga and possibly an anime. It was obviously a spin-off game, and I think they might have had something, some weird name that might actually be what this is in reference to. Could be wrong, but I don't know, it seems familiar, so maybe that's what it is, it's a reference, maybe.
Just tell them you're after the legendary sea monster, Papuna, or that you're looking to taste
bumper on. If you do so, they won't suspect a thing and will gladly take you aboard. If it is what I'm thinking of, then it is a freaking weird-ass series from what I saw of the game. Because, Jesus Christ, that's some wacky stuff going down there. Seriously, some, you know, Japanese manga and anime, you know, especially older ones, have some of the most crazy, you know, collection of characters and scenarios. What a thought-provoking answer.
Let's see. Number 38. Yeah, now we've just suddenly gone to 38. Nickname is Gilgamesh.
Wait, is that a play on words? Question for Kyousuke-senpai, famous for his countless sport achievements. Often play baseball, but I get hit with a ball almost every time. It's a lot. How do you dodge the ball, Kyousuke-senpai?
What?
Answer, catch it with my ass cheeks.
I'm impressed by his resourcefulness and, frankly, his bluntness. Why would you catch it with your ass?
Let's see. 37 Sidecar. I heard that you have developed robotic cat tools. What kind of tools are those?
Answer, anywhere, door, Horomon, wrinkle.
Now, I've never seen the show. Probably got manga. Never read it.
Again, going back to Zeta Players, that's where I originally heard about this character, because, you know, it's in some of those games. Plus, it was also referenced in Dark Opera 2, wasn't it? It was Nanaka was her name, wasn't it? She was clearly referencing that cat, Doraemon or something like that. This is clearly that. They just changed the wording a bit on the name to avoid copyrights.
As you know, the Dohormon wrinkle is manufactured with great care in a factory surrounded by the green wealth of nature. The whole assembly line is made in such a fashion that it can be completely torn down within 4 hours without leaving trace. So this tool allows you to produce this very Dohormon wrinkle wherever you are. When you use it, you just need to leave the container and wait for a few hours before it's completely filled with Dohormon wrinkle of unsurpassed quality. Based on this criminal advantage is exactly what one would expect of robotic cat tools. I don't know what kind of people would be in primary target of the tool, though.
That might indeed happen. Let's see. 36, Katachi. Question for Kosuke-senpai, who still had two more transformations to go through. Heard that with the last transformation, something unthinkable will be attached to you. What is it?
Answer, after my next transformation, I'll turn into a hellish abomination. After the final transformation, I'll have bird poo on my head.
Okay.
I don't know, I'm like thinking maybe it's like a reference. I don't know. I can't. It's like I was thinking of Dragon Ball Z, but I don't remember a scenario where a final transformation led to dog crap on your head. That might indeed happen.
Let's see. Number 35, nickname VU. Question for the famous Kosuke-senpai, rumored to have surpassed Presley himself. What's the title of your popular song that became a huge hit in the Western world but wasn't available for sale in Japan?
Answer, Kimchi. I was going for something that had a similar ring to Sugiyaki by Sakamoto-san. It was released under his title in America and gained tremendous popularity. By the way, the original title of the song is Stop the War.
I'm impressed by his voiceness.
Let's see. Number 34, Kurikami. Kuro is black, right? And Kami is God, so would that be Black God? Is that your nickname? Please fill out the blanks. It's okay because... Answer, it's okay because I'm the
high pitch one from Kraken! You're awesome!
But I might indeed have... Let's see.
33. I'm the Overlord nickname. Question for Kosuke-senpai, who's known to be able to run faster than the speed of sound.
They get serious. What lies on the other side of the speed of sound?
Answer, I only caught a glimpse of it, but I saw a signboard with written on it.
Perhaps it wasn't Sutaya. It could have been Yatayan, as in Awesome You Did It, or maybe even Sugaya, or mated pair, not quite sure which pair of species. It was all too fast, and I couldn't really make anything out of it. Maybe another reference, I don't know. It's so interesting. Feels like this might just be the right of an excuse to make some really random references. Let's see. Number 42, Cookie Butter Kaiser. Replace the asterisk symbol, that is called an asterisk, right? With words to make an... make a four words idiomatic expression. Why is it worded like to make an? Should just be a. Looks inside. Answer, looks tough, soft inside. So, isn't that like a, well, kind of like a description of tsundere characters, you know, where they're like, or maybe that was a different trope of character, where, actually it might be, actually, you know, a character that looks, you know, intimidating, but is a big softie. I think that might be a different one. I don't know my, you know, all the terminology of this stuff. So interesting. Let's see. Number 31, nickname El Taki. A question for the super high class tennis player Kyousuke Senpai. I think I can see an aura around you when you play. Don't worry, it's just a garden spirit. From the looks of it, he was involved in tennis, and every time I pick up a tennis racket, he bears. Until the match is over, he whispers into my ear what the score is at the moment, like 40 love and such. I mean, it's not like I can't take a look at the scoreboard myself. I feel like this might be another reference. I know there are, you know, tennis-based animes, so maybe it's one of those. Well, I didn't know this. I'm not an anime aficionado. I don't really know all that much anime. It's like I keep saying, I can't remember the last time I watched any anime. Or even read any manga for that matter. Let's see. Do the manga sites that I read back in the day even still exist? I don't even know. Number 30, nickname Roni. Still a question for Kyousuke Senpai. Who is Winsy Free Garigari Kun Ice Pop? What's the trick? Answer, just get the Garigari Wave. Garigari Wave is a stream of good luck for winning free Garigari Kuns. Is that another reference? I don't know. That might indeed happen. Let's see. Number 29, nickname Victory. A question for Kyousuke Senpai, who's won 100 free Garigari Kuns in a row. What the hell is a Garigari Kun? I don't know. How can you tell which Ice Pop is a winning one and which isn't? Yeah, so just get on the Garigari Wave. Garigari Wave is a dream of good luck for winning free Garigari Kuns. What a thoughtful good answer. Let's see. Number 28, nickname Kyoda Toshia. Question for Kyosuke Senpai, famous for winning 7 free Garigari Kuns in a row. How do you win free ice cream? What the hell is a Garigari Kun? And why is it not highlighted in the Bulbapedia thing? Because I have no idea what that is. And so just get on the Garigari Wave, and also why don't you guys put your effort into something else? I don't want our school to be like this, all this Garigari stuff. Hans, ask a different question. What a thought-broken answer. Let's see. Number 27, nickname Kanata. Christopher Cousins Ember ran into Bigfoot on a snowy mountain and befriended him. What kind of person is Bigfoot? And so the Bigfoot that I know is a pretty normal guy. Its foot size is running around 28.5 centimeters, not really enough to be called Bigfoot. He'd also... It's because I couldn't see the word. And also, his hair wasn't as thick as I thought. Well, the fur of his chest is pretty thick, alright. Maybe that's what allows him to survive in the harsh environment of snowy mountains. But his back is unexpectedly smooth, so much that if he fell asleep on his back, he could freeze to death. When I asked him, he said that he usually puts something warm underneath his back before going to sleep. His unkempt, disheveled hair gave him a wild look, but it didn't look dirty. And if he, say, pretended to be a musician, I suppose it'd be a piece of cake for him to get a board to play. Basically saying musicians are all hairy. When I suggested that he came with me to Japan for sightseeing, he said, Natsume, don't they say, he that will lie will steal in your country. I don't want to get hassled by cops. He was a stubborn but honest fellow. This is so interesting. Let's see. Can you imagine, like, if someone drew, like, a manga panel for every one of these scenarios? How ridiculous they would look. Nickname TMY number 26. Quest of an Atom Sniper who loves roller coasters more than eating. I'm going to an amusement park with my girlfriend, but I'm extremely afraid of riding roller coasters. If you ask me to ride one with her, I'm gonna refuse and still look like a man. Answer: is it fast? That's so thrilling. Is it high? That's so exciting. Does it have a vertical loop? I'm all for it. But when the three of them come together, count me out. That might indeed happen. Good God, how long is this gonna go? We're up to 45 minutes. It's gonna be an extended part here. It's gonna be like 50 minutes, maybe even an hour of Kyousuke's complete nonsensical Q&A. Let's see. Number 60, Jesus Christ, how many are there? Nicknamed Dagger Hero. Question, you've traveled across the world. Please share with me one memory that will forever stay with you. Answer, one time when I was overseas, there was a hotel boy I became friends with, and he asked me to teach him Japanese. So I told him that when he goes inside a room, he should say, I'm Kondo. And when he leaves, he should say, I was Nishimura. Don't trust Kyosuke to help you learn Japanese, evidently. I'm afraid he still says this to every Japanese tourist that stops at the hotel. My heart still aches with pain every time I think about this. This is so interesting. Let's see. Do these ever run out? 59, nicknamed Bye Bye Kawawazaki. Question of the question, without Sami Sambo, scaled ever stressed in our business suit and short pants. What was the biggest hurdle you encountered? I had a hard time giving a satisfying answer to every mountain climber I passed as to why I was climbing in the business suit and short pants. It didn't help that half of my butt was visible. Every time I said that I wasn't doing the climbing just because there was a mountain and that the way I was dressed was itself the reason. They'd always go, eh? Or if it was a foreigner, pardon, and give me that, are you stupid? Or if it was a foreigner, crazy kind of look. I mean, I feel like the looks would all be the same. They just go, what the frickin' hell are you doing? And I might need Adam. Let's see. 58, nicknamed Saito. What is the all ingredient that one antibiotic painkiller is made of? Answer, the all ingredient is sponge cake. That might indeed happen. I'm slowly losing brain cells. Let's see. Nickname Manmo 57. A question for Natsume Senpai, who was the honorary president of the Japanese Antibiotic Painkiller Research Association? One of the ingredients of that antibiotic painkiller is kindness, but what's the other one? As a sponge cake. Clearly you didn't read the previous question. Wow, I didn't know this. This is like the equivalent of people who post on forums, you know, a post that has already been posted multiple times. It's like, have you not seen the other posts? Let's see. Number 56, nickname Kanai Mazaru. Question for Natsumi Senpai, big expert in the medical world, one of the ingredients in that antibiotic painkiller is kindness, but what is yelling? Wasn't this question just asked? Is the other convenient? As a sponge cake, okay. Is it an antibiotic painkiller attack this time? It is so much more fun doing this, I'm gonna quit this school. What a thought-provoking answer. I thought maybe that was the last one that was just saying, oh, screw this shit. Let's see. Now 55. Oh no, it's the KKK. I heard that one of the ingredients in that antibiotic painkiller is kindness. But is it in the right part of the capsule or the left? You know, let's actually see if it actually does say that. Can't be, surely not. Nope, it is. It does say KKK. You crazy? Why? Why would you have that as your nickname? Sure, this is in Japan, Lord, but I mean, I don't know, maybe they just somehow knock you into the KKK. I mean, you know, foreign to them, wouldn't it? Answer, who the hell cares about that? The kindness goes in the right part, sponge cake in the left. Okay, stop asking me stupid questions. This is so interesting. We're coming up, 50 minutes now. Let's see. Number 54, nickname Villon. What's the difference between a half merman and a fish man? Answer, Fishman is fish in a human shape, half merman. Judging by the morphology, it's someone who is a fish from dusk till dawn. And from dawn till dusk, he's just a normal office worker in straw's handles. At least, this one is a human. Most obvious difference, as you can see, is that one of them is a human and the other is not. Riveting. That might indeed happen. Let's see. Number 53, nickname Relaxed and Happy. Question. A question for that same as Emma. When are you out there? Eat something you dislike. What do you do? Answer. I got a group of people who share the same sentiment and raise a demonstration. What a thought-broken answer. Can you imagine? Imagine that. Like, Kyousuke growing up. He's just like, doesn't want to eat his vegetables or whatever. He's picky with that. And he's just like, no, you gotta eat that. And he's like, no. And he brings in, like, Masato, Kengo, Rin, and Ricky. He's like, we're gonna do a demonstration so I don't have to eat that stuff. Let's see. Number 52, nickname Optink. Question, how do I go about invading the Earth? What? Is the answer, is it really okay for me to talk about this? Well, okay, first of all, you need to do something that make a big impact on the Earth atmosphere's attention, for instance, blow up the sun. I mean, if you blow up the sun, I don't think you really need to invade Earth anymore, because it'd be fucked. This will make everyone on the planet go, oh, you gotta be kidding, that's your chance. Or wait, it'd be night on the other side of the planet, sorry, you'd have to blow up the moons and the tents as well. That way, everyone on the other side will go, oh, you've gotta be kidding too. Then strike while the iron's hot. I think the iron would not be very hot at that point. That might indeed happen. Let's see. Now 51, nickname Tanasi. Sinbad, I have a question. If there were an old hag living next to you and harassing you by making noises day and night, how would you deal with it? Answer, endure. Okay, that might indeed happen. Let's see. Number 50, nickname Wall Jump. Every time I eat Odin or something like this, I end up using chicken as a straw. Is it some kind of conspiracy? Answer, I used to do that when I was a kid and would always burn my tongue, and I remembered that thanks to your email, so now I have to do it next time I eat Odin. Damn it! Conspiracy? Hell if I know. Your email looks a little more like a conspiracy to me. What a thought-provoking answer. Does this ever end? Let's see. It's got to, surely. Number 49, nickname MHI. Please tell me how to drink Coke so it tastes better. Answer, use Chikuwa as a straw. What the hell is Chikuwa? Why is there no Bulbapedia for that? What a thought-broken answer. Let's see. Number 48, nickname Freestar456. What's the correct way to eat avocado? Use Chikuwa as a straw as well. Can you at least tell me what the hell that is? I'm impressed by his greatness. Let's see. I'm 47, nickname Poco. There are so many ways to use Rakua, for example as a flute. What ways are there to use it always? Answer, I really gotta hand it to you. Miss all these questions, just still ask about ways to use Rakua. You have some guts. Alright, I'll give you an honest answer. Not some chain and letter kind of nonsense. Just eat it. Stuff your stomach full of it. What a thought-provoking answer. Let's see. M46, nickname HK. If you smashed the ribcage of that batter with your 165 kilometer an hour plus gyro ball and vowed to never use it again, did you come up with another technique? Answer, I did. It's a miracle pitch called the disappearing pitcher. The instant I release the ball, I disappear from the view of the batter. That supposedly improves the center field's response. I'm impressed by his laziness. Let's see. Number 46, nickname You. When you wear high socks and roll them down on your legs, they look like donuts. I have no idea what the correct term is for this. Please tell me what it's really called. Answer, that's a part of cool biz. All office workers do it in the summer. So interesting. I hope it is anyway, because, I mean, 54 minutes of this. I can't split this into like two halves. That'd be ridiculous. There's going to be one long video for this section. Let's see. Nickname Shin 44. Please tell me of the perfectly elegant excuse for being late.
And so when I woke up, I found myself confined in a prison. I could only hear the sound of water dripping. Apparently it was inside a cave. Not a ray of light reached in from the outside. I was imprisoned after having learned the secret. I had to pass it on to Jesse no matter what. I put my life on a line to the sake of completing my mission and commence my escape. This might also be a reference to something, but I'm unsure.
One after another, the agents in black overcoats attacked me, together with my fellow partner, prisoner Lily. I was escaping from the facility of the organization. It was a merciless battle. Jack the Gunslinger, Alex the Destroyer, Wolf the Black Reaper. It was nothing but one renowned assassin after another. Every time I pulled the trigger of my Beretta, and the bullets pierced their bodies, it was as if the bullets struck through my own heart. I started feeling how meaningless this carnage was. We were advancing along the underground roads that was very much like Tartarus itself. But at the end of the path waiting for us was the A-class agent, Cerberus. Flamethrower turned the tunnel into a sea of flames. The battle was draining towards its conclusion. My bullet went through his heart. But before he breathed his last, he detonated the bomb vest he was wearing. If that secret came to light, it would spell destruction for the organization. The bomb took Lily's legs. It was impossible for both of us to escape. I didn't care if I'd been alive with her. I didn't care so long as it meant that that meaningless battle would be over. But she pointed her gun at me and said, "I'm not going with you. If you want to die together with me, I can shoot you down right here. You will live." I ran. I ran so far away. No, I ran through the blazing corridor of fire. Not a single thought on my mind. I could see the light. I rubbed my teary eyes and dashed off towards it. And now I'm late.
That's a hell of an excuse for being late.
What a thought-provoking answer.
Honestly, you know, they always going on about Masato and his ridiculous excuses. I think he's learned from Kyousuke. Let's see. 43, nickname Kenny Ichiro. How can Japan's national soccer team win?
Answer, well, sorry, difficult enough to win the group league. It's really sad when we lost against Australia in the first match. Thanks to that, we have to win the next match with Croatia, no matter what it takes.
As everyone keeps saying, the Japanese team is weak in scoring. The most important thing would be to score a goal. After that, Kawaguchi-san will somehow show a miracle save, and they will let the score change from zero. There's zero chance of winning against Brazil. Well, they're said to be the favourites of the tournament, but even them would be difficult to win every match. This team has received on 13th of June 2006.
Wait, is that? Would that imply that Little Buster came out around 2006 then?
Maybe that was the case.
But you know, if Japan went up against Brazil, yeah, they'd have no chance.
What a thought-provoking answer. I mean, I don't really care much for football, or soccer as it's called in the US, you know.
Although, didn't they, in a World Cup, didn't they get absolutely destroyed by Germany at one point in one of the World Cups a while back? And it was... yeah. But they'd probably still win if they went up against Japan, though. Even in... yeah, whatever. Doesn't matter. Let's see. We're still on the madness. That is number 42. Nickname, Emu. Question for Natsumi-senpai. The most influential hairstyle expert on the planet.
Nice to you. Were planning to get a mystery haircut that you'd end up regretting. What was it like?
That's why I definitely have ended up regretting getting that hairstyle, but I'm glad that I didn't, because I didn't want to regret it. If you wonder what it was like, the plan was to fix my long, that point hair, in the shape of the question mark. I wanted to become the kind of inquisitive person who's constantly wondering about something. I still get a slight chill when I think about it. There's no doubt I would have ended up regretting my decision.
That honestly sounds stupid enough to be believable that you would have this ridiculous idea of getting a haircut like that and then realizing, like, nah, that would be a bad idea. It's just so interesting.
Let's see. We're very close to the hour mark now. I'm 41, nickname Ari. Question, Natsumi-senpai, can you tell me what that innovative function is that only your cell phone has?
Answer, it's the latest security solution to the cell phone industry. When someone older than me opens my cell phone, it blows up.
I'm impressed by his business, and now we just hit the hour mark. Jesus Christ, let's see.
Number 40, nicknamed Mary.
What was the greatest difficulty you had to go through when completing the mission so far?
Answer, it happened once without my neck was disconnected from the body. It's a miracle that it could be connected back. At that time, I really thought it was the end of the line for me.
Wow, I didn't know this. You had to, I mean, maybe that explains everything. That's why he's so crazy.
Let's see.
Number 39, nicknamed Poco. Question, what's the worst injury you've ever had in your life?
Haven't we had a question from Poco already?
Answer, when I was small, my finger once got caught under a seesaw. That was rough. I'm talking about the weight of a person here, you know? You have no idea how much that hurts.
Wow, I didn't know this. What was it again?
Finger got caught under a seesaw. That was rough.
Honestly, is this just one of the writers telling their own personal stories? Like, yeah, you have no idea how painful that childhood moment was.
Let's see.
Number 90, Jesus Christ. I can't go on like this.
Nicknamed Clace. I heard that you had the special Little Buster song that you use when celebrating one of your members' birthdays. If you don't mind, please tell me the lyrics.
Answer, what is your reason for living? To shed tears, to spill blood. The number of orphans is increasing. They're starving. Look at the good land of Afghan. Come now, be born. Genghis, that shall be your name. To Genghis.
Whatever you pronounce that, I'm impressed by his braveness.
How is that a birthday song?
Let's see.
89, Jesus Christ. Why? How'd that be funny if nicknamed Jesus Christ appeared? Freedom Red. Question for Kyousuke Senpai, why does this never end? Who used to host a TV workout program? What was the toughest thing about it?
Answer, I was delighted when I got a chance and was full of enthusiasm. I thought I could pull it off with a confident look. But then the video went on for an hour. But after the first broadcast, I received a wave of complaints from the parents, like,
who's that ruffian? His stiff expression doesn't go with his light movements. It's creepy. Oh, my child got muscle cramps because of you, and so on.
It was then that I realized how vicious my face appears.
I mean, he does have a bit of an intimidating looking expression on his face sometimes. He has that villain look. But when I tried my best to smile, I received another wave of complaints like,
who's that ruffian with that hostile smile? His facial muscles don't even twitch when he smiles, that's just creepy. Or, my child got muscle cramps because of you.
Wow, I didn't know this.
Let's see, how much more can we possibly go through? 88, Takata Katam. I wonder if there's a trophy related to going through all of these. And by trophy, I mean achievements.
Question for that, Semi-Sambo famous for being able to kill with his own eyes.
How do you kill someone with your eyes? I guess it's something like a beam.
As you know, I literally take out my eyes and pierce the enemy with them.
Well, that's interesting indeed. Let's see.
87, nicknamed Kanupu. Kanupu.
Question for Natsumi Senpai, famous for his unrivaled angelic voice. What do you have to watch out for during recording?
That's the most important thing is to stuff my nose full of peanuts. I believe it has to do with the way I breathe. If I fail to do it, my voice will no longer be angelic, but become deaf grunting instead. By the way, if I get too excited and the peanuts ring out, it's game over. My voice will become deaf grunting again.
Ah, so interesting. Let's see.
You know, if we go down, if the numbers switch again, they stop from going down, then we're done here. It's like, I'm pretty sure there's like, I don't know. I'm not sure actually. Is there like a skip button for text you've read previously? It's like, basically, if that happens, we'll save the rest for the next playthrough. It's like, we're gonna do in the next route, we get to this point, we skip all the ones all the way up till the most recent one and continue from there, because this is getting ridiculous. I mean, it was getting ridiculous basically at the start, it's just been insanity. 86, Pop and Mop.
Pop-pee-poo-pa-poo, Natsumi-san. Pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-po. I got a question. Are you studying language? You better do so. Well, see ya.
Answer, what's up? Hey, what happened?
Tanaka.
I'm impressed by his resistance.
Let's see.
85, Natsume Juyu. Quest from Natsume Senpo, met aliens and was almost abducted. How did you get away unscathed? Answer, hijacked their UFO. Fair enough. Wow, I didn't know this. Let's see. 84, nickname Kosan. When I accidentally end up calling my female homeroom teacher mom, how can I naturally get out of the situation? Answer, you only need to press her further. You're my mother, aren't you? I'm impressed by this. How he takes it the complete worst way possible. It's like, mom, everyone's looking at me. Actingly, just like, you just called her mom. And he just takes it to an opposite extreme. I'd like to fuck. He's like, what?
Let's see. Number 83, nickname Genzao. Question, for Natsumi Sanmo's study toilets of the world. Which toilet left the biggest impact on you so far?
Answer, the one where when you press the button, and the water jet springs up in front of you and washes your face. It definitely left an impact. It wouldn't surprise me if there was a toilet that did that, honestly.
This is so interesting. Let's see. 82, nickname LP.
Question. President of Kyousuke Senpai, who saved the turtle, went to the Dragon Palace and came back with Tritris. Did you try opening it? Well, I didn't, but the mistress kid, Katsuzi again, of the famous Inoue-san, nicked it off me. When I met him on the following day, he had become Inoue Katsuji-san, what it when he was old. For some reason, I got all polite in front of him. Could this still be a reference to that freaking anime, whatever it is? It feels like it. This is so interesting.
Let's see. 81, nickname Hononono. I heard that you used to work for FBI. What does this abbreviation stand for? Final Black Yatsura? Yatsura? So interesting. Let's see. 82.
Question on Natsumi Senpai, famous for dribbling 10 Brazilian players in a soccer game. What was the reaction at that time? It was a circle how they kept tussling with my after image even after I scored that goal. It shows how fast I was. But my after image stayed for too long and even my teammates started passing the ball to it. Where's the real you, Natsume? There was a lot of confusion on the fields. What a thought broken answer. Jesus Christ. See. At least it's still kind of going down number-wise. Chan-san. What a name. Best one out to me, Senpai. I heard that you had a role in Sky Castle. What role was that? I want to hear everything down to the small details. Answer, the other legendary technique, booth radio in the sky that appeared in the climax. It was me who was operating it. I believe you could see me dialing numbers at an incredible speed behind the window.
I didn't know this.
Why are we still doing this? Let's see. 76, Red Bean Soup. Question for the magic user Natsumi Senpai. What does your greatest magic spell, Kleenex, do? When you accidentally take out too many tissues, it allows you to put them back in the tissue box. What a thought-provoking answer. Oh, Jesus Christ. Please, no more. Let's see. 77, Kirikiri Kirin. Question for Natsumi Senpai, receive the new Olympic event for the upcoming Olympics in 2008. What kind of event is it? The 100 meter of turning over in your sleep. It's literally the kind of event where you have to cover a distance of 100 meters by turning over in your sleep. The impossible, goddamn crucial event now requires concentration or physical exam. Do you think it's groundbreaking? Well, maybe. If you were turned over and fell out of bed and were very heavy, I'm impressed by his pervasiveness. Let's see. 66 MH. I heard that you, Natsumi Senpai, have some sort of mantra that you repeat every time you wake up so that your brain cells don't die from reading all this. Could you tell me more about it? Answer, Sunday is what I say every morning. It's like a prayer that I'd really be so. What? That it's really be so. Well, it still usually turns out to be a weekday.
Wow, I didn't know this.
Why are we still doing this? Nickname Alien number 75. Pee-poo-pee-poo.
poo poo pee 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 poo pa pee koo kee pee kee.
Okay, what is it now, Tanaka? I don't know. That might indeed happen, though, apparently.
Let's see. How's the teacher not back? We've been at this for an hour now. Nickname Pop1374. Question: before a falling star disappears, what can you wish for? Answer: I've thought about it. It's just a fraction of a second, so it shouldn't be longer than a few syllables. One time I accidentally said boom, and people regret it afterwards. Luckily, my wish wasn't granted. Well, if it's something with only two syllables, Tosu is about all I can think of. So wish for the falling star to fall on Sue, capital of Mia Prefecture.
Okay, so interesting.
Let's see. Number 73, nickname Fifi.
How many times can you repeat a wish before a fallen star disappears?
If it's Tosu, about four times. Yes, Tosu, 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 and like that. If you do so, I believe the four fallen stars will level in the air prefecture.
That might need to happen.
Let's see.
72, renewal PO. Question when I assume Sandman, the first person to discover that pudding with soy sauce tastes like sea urchin. How did you find this out? Actually, it was the other way around. The first time I tried sea urchin, I thought to myself, this is just like pudding with soy sauce. What a thought-provoking answer.
Let's see. 71, Akimao. Question for an Atsumi Samba, who can freely go inside a monitor. What does it feel like?
Answer, what does it feel like? In truth, I was shocked when I realized that I could even do something like that. Honestly, I was expecting to break the fourth wall. It's like, I was shocked to realize that I'm a character in a visual novel. That is so interesting.
Let's see.
I'm a Stanley nicknamed AAA. I heard there exists a bird that looks like a person's face. Who does it, what does it chirping sound like?
And so it goes, where you go? I mean, it's just a chirping, but since the bird looks like someone's face, you end up responding. But even if you do, it will still repeat, where you go? Well, I didn't know this. One more. Let's see. Fittingly on 69. NFM. The question for Natsumi Senpai, who used to live in a candy house, what did you do about the toilets? Flushed with cola.
Wow, I didn't know this. Scared of studying Jesus Christ. Yeah, next lesson is religious studies, so it's quite literal. Oops, I almost got too excited about this. You spent a whole hour reading this nonsense. But hopefully I remember the number 69. That was the last entry we read. So, you know, next time we pick this up in the next round, when we come to this nonsense again, and skip all of the entries up to that point. Damn, that's just... I don't think I'll even remember that. This is just... Oh. Well, can we move on from this now?